Good morning students. Today we are continuing our chapter, that is biology, our biology first chapter, life process. In previous video we will study about life process, what is life process. Now we are going to study the important part of this chapter and the first topic, that is nutrition. What is nutrition and types of nutrition and modes of nutrition? In this video we will cover the whole portion of nutrition. Now we will start. What is nutrition? Nutrition is the process of intake and utilization of nutrients, food, by an organism in various life process. Why we are eating food? In previous video we will discuss for living, for why we are eating food, to get nourishment, to get nutrients, right? So nutrition is the process by which we will get nutrients, we will utilize the nutrients, whatever which nutrients are present, what any nutrients that is present in the food, if we eat that food we will get that nutrients. So the process in which we will utilize the nutrients or food, that process is known as nutrition. Means nutrition is the process, and it is the very important process by an organism. The substance, what is nutrients? Why are talking about nutrients and the process that we get nutrients, it is called nutrition. But what is nutrients? So nutrients is the substance that is present in the food, like carbohydrate, protein, fats. These all are the nutrients that are very important for functioning of our organs and functioning of all the cells in our body. If they will get that all the nutrients that they want, if it will get proper nutrients, then our all the cells will do the work properly. So the substance that is needed to keep them living is called nutrients. There are various type of nutrients on the basis of functions they perform. Now first things, in biology there are two type of nutrients. One is inorganic nutrients and one is organic nutrients. Then first we will talk about what is inorganic and organic, then we will talk about different type of nutrients on the basis of their functions. Okay, now first inorganic. What is inorganic nutrients? That nutrients which is in a simplest form, like water, then sodium, chlorine. These all the nutrients that are also important for our body, if we have to take these nutrients also in a small amount. So this type of nutrients is called inorganic nutrients. But what is organic nutrients? We will already discuss in chemistry also. If carbon is present in any compound, that type of compound is called organic compound. Same thing here. What is organic nutrients? A nutrients in which carbon is present, that is called organic nutrients, like carbohydrate, protein, fats. These all are the nutrients in which carbon is present. So simplest, what is inorganic and what is organic? If this question comes in exam also, what is organic and inorganic nutrients? So you have to write only simple. If the question asks in a one mark question, then you have to write, if carbon is present in nutrients, then it is called organic nutrients. If carbon is not present in nutrients, then it is called an inorganic nutrients. So understand what is organic and what is inorganic nutrients. Now we will see the nutrients on the basis of their functions. First, some nutrients have a work to provide energy to the body. Why we are eating? To get an energy, right? If we will eat, then we will get energy. So some nutrients that will give us energy instantly, okay, like carbohydrate and fats. That's why whenever we will drink glucose, we get instant energy. Okay, so in a nutrients, in a food in which carbohydrate and fats is present, that type of food is called energy giving food. One is bodybuilding foods. Everyone knows that. We will hear also the bodybuilders, they continuously, they regularly, they will eat egg, meat, they will drink milk, right? Meat, egg, milk, they will continuously eating this in a large proportion. Why? Because these type of foods have a nutrients that makes their body building body. That's why it is called bodybuilding foods. Why? Because in this food protein and mineral salts are present, that have a work, these nutrients have a work to make a body. Regulating foods, this type of foods, if the injury and any damage to any cells and any part of a body, then these nutrients have a work to repair the damage and the injuries. And these nutrients are vitamins and minerals, right? When we are talking about the eye is weak, why I am not seeing clearly? Why? Because they have a less of vitamins. So these are the repairing foods, in which are the repairing foods in which vitamins and minerals is present. So on the various of nutrients functions, on the functions of the nutrients, these are the classification of the various type of nutrients. So I hope you will understand the topic of nutrition, what is nutrients and what is nutrition. Now we will see modes of nutrition. Mode of nutrition, there are two type of mode of nutrition. One is autotrophic nutrition and one is heterotrophic nutrition. What is autotrophic and heterotrophic, we will already discuss in our lower classes also, from 5th standard and from, I think now in the syllabus it is comes from a 1st standard also, autotroph and heterotrophs. So I will remind you what is autotroph and what is heterotroph. Auto means self, and trophic means to make. So an organism that makes their own food, that makes their own nutritions, that is, that type of organisms are called autotrophs, and the mode of nutrition is called autotrophic nutrition. Means the animal, the organisms that makes their own food, that type of organisms are called autotroph, and the mode of nutrition is called autotrophic nutrition. Now what is heterotroph? Hetero means it depends on other. It depends on other. Trophic means synthesized, and nutrition means heterotrophic nutrition is a process by which heterotroph animals get depends on the other animal for their foods. Means the animal, the organisms that depends for their food nourishment on the other organisms, that type of organisms are called heterotroph organisms, and the process is called heterotrophic nutrition. In lower classes we will study that plants make their own food, that's why it is called autotroph, and human beings and animals eat the plant, means we are depends on a plant for our food requirement, that's why we are called heterotrophs. And the process by plants make their food is called, they get their nourishment is called autotrophic nutrition, and the animals that depends on a plant, That's why we are called heterotrophs, and the process is called, by getting a nutrients, is called heterotrophic nutrients. I hope you will understand what is autotrophic and what is heterotrophic. Now, autotrophic nutrients are classified into two categories. One is photoautotrophic and one is chemoautotrophic. What is photo? The word photo refers light. We will study in earlier classes also. Photosynthesis means plants makes their own food in the presence of sunlight. That's why the process is called photosynthesis. Why? Because they make their food on the presence of sunlight, means presence in a light. That's why it use photo. Synthesis means they make their food. Now here, photoautotrophic means here autotrophic nourishments, the animal make their food by using light. That's why these type of organisms are called photoautotrophic and photoautotrophs, and the nourishment is called, the process is called photoautotrophic. Here chemo means chemical. They are using chemicals for making their food. Now question arise, sir, we didn't study anywhere about chemoautotrophic. Now this is a new for you, but some organisms are living in a ground, in a earth crust, so there they doesn't get the sunlight. Then how they will make their food? So they will make their food by using chemicals from their surroundings. We will study deeply about these topics after this. First we will see what is heterotrophic nutrients. There are three types of heterotrophic nutrients. One is saprophytic, parasitic and halozoic. So now the question, sir, heterotrophic means they are depends on other. Then how it will categorize in different? So each and every animals doesn't have the similar mode of nutrition. Means we are eating rice, then we will say mosquito, you also eat rice, then it is possible? No. So heterotroph animals also have different mode of nutrition. One is saprophytic, one is parasitic and one is holozoic. In saprophytic, which animals comes? The animals that get their nourishment on the dead and decaying matter. Means they live on a dead and decaying matter. That type of called saprophytic, like fungus, mushrooms. What happens? If any part of plant will fall down and dead, what happens? On that part, mushrooms will grow up. So, the saprophytic nourishment in which organisms get their nourishment from the dead and decaying matter. Okay, understand? Dead and decaying matter. What is parasitic? So, parasitic is also a mode of nutrition in which the organisms get their nourishment from a host organisms. Means they live on a other organisms to complete their food requirement. Like you will hear in our hair, jew means slice, lice, jew. We have word in Hindi and the English word is lice. Okay, now they will live like mosquito. Mosquito get their nourishment from our body. So it is, our body is a host, and from the host the mosquito will get their food. So that mosquito is called parasitic. They use the parasitic nutrients. Holozoic means the organisms that do that get the complete food requirement by its own, like human being, like amoeba. They will make their own food. Means if I want the nourishment, what I do? I will make itself. I will go and pluck a fruit and eat by own self. So this type of animals, this type of organisms comes in a halozoic nutrition. So this is the structure of nutritions, mode of nutritions of autotrophic and heterotrophic. Now we will discuss some examples and we will see some examples of autotrophic and heterotrophic nutritions. Now, autotrophic nutritions. First, phototrophic. In phototrophic, the examples comes like green plants is use phototrophic nutritions, and some animals like cyanobacteria also use phototrophic nutritions. Means they will make their own food by using light. That's why it will come in a photoautotrophic category. Now, in chemoautotrophic category, purple sulfur bacteria, they live in a warm water. You hear the warm waters. In warm water, some bacteria are living, and they use the hydrogen sulfide chemical to make their food. And another one is nitrite bacteria. Means they are, another name is nitrite bacteria is called nitrosomonas. So they live in a root of pulses like a pea and gram. They live on the roots of these plants. What happens, what they will do, it will fix the nitrogen from the atmosphere to the soil. So that's, they are also doing nitrogen fixation work also. So these two bacteria are coming in autotrophic, they are using chemo autotrophic nutritions. Now, mode of nutritions in heterotrophic nutritions. First is saprophytic, second one is parasitic, and last one is holozoic. So saprophytic, they are get their nourishment from dead and decaying like fungus and bacteria. What they will do, here it is a plant. First, the fungus will, this is a dead plant, the fungus will break these plants into a simplest form, and then will get their nourishment like mushrooms. First it will break the complex into simplest compound, then they will get their nourishment from that simplest compound. Parasitic, they live on a host organism like lice, means zoo, are living in our head and get the nourishment from our hair. Holozoic, like humans and amoeba, they will get their food by own. So they are come in a holozoic nutritions. So in this video we will study about nutritions and mode of nutritions. Now in our next video we will deeply study about other things of nutritions and all these things in deeply. So thank you.